वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. यस ऑफलाइन चिल्ड्रन काइंडली मेंटेन साइलेंस. वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज पोएट्री टुडे बिकॉज यू आर हैविंग रिवीजन टेस्ट. वी हैव ऑलरेडी रिवाइज ऑल द पोएम्स बट इफ यू हैव इंसिस्टेड बिकॉज वी आर हैविंग द टेस्ट टुडे ओनली. टुडे यू आर हैविंग टू टेस्ट सो इंग्लिश टेस्ट विल बी शेयर्ड शार्प एट 4 PM. फाइन. सो विल बी डूइंग द जिस्ट ऑफ ऑल द पोएम्स एंड देन MCQs. Clear? In the first poem, Dust of Snow, which is written by Robert Frost, a poet based on, you can say, the poet who loves nature, who has projected simple ideas and turned it into beautiful thoughts. Fine? So, Dust of Snow is a very small poem written by American poet. Dhyan se sunne, whatever word I'll be using. Fine? Then I can ask any of you. Robert Frost, nationality is American. So, American poet, the poem is set on a wintry day. The weather is quite cold, fine, icy cold. In the first stanza, poet describes a simple natural occurring, a simple natural happening, fine. What is that happening? The snow is falling heavily. Snowflakes have covered the tops of the trees or everything. Yes, Daksh, you're talking. I ask you to shift in that row. Kindly move to that row. Kindly, I'm using the word kindly for you. This is your goodness only. So, snow-covered trees and snowflakes everywhere. Poet is standing under the hemlock tree. Fine. Hemlock is considered poisonous. And a tree of ill omen, a sign of ill omen. So poet was standing there. There was no, you can say, movement. Everything seems to be dull and boring to him. And then what happens? There was suddenly a movement after alightment of a crow. Fine. A crow was there on a tree. And just because of the movement of the crow, the dust of snowflakes fell upon the poet. Crow is also considered a symbol of ill omen, the way tree, hemlock tree is considered. So when in second stanza, the falling of snowy flakes and the scene, in the first stanza, there is no movement. In the second stanza, when snowflakes fell upon the shoulders of, you can say, or on the poet, it leaves a tremendous effect on the poet. What was that effect? It changed his mood. Suddenly, there was a change of mood in the, it gladdens the heart of the poet. Otherwise, he was feeling very out of the place. He was feeling low and it gladdened the heart of the poet. Fine. He realizes that falling of snowy flakes on him actually saved the day. What saved his day? Falling of snowflakes saved his day. So he has no regret that at least some part of the day was good enough for him. It saved his day. Moments of snowfall put very positive effects on him. Clear? And they have brought a change of his mood. It uplifted the mood of the poet. So what do we learn from this poem? That even small moments can change or affect your life, number one. Secondly, we should not have preconceived notions about ill omens and such kind of things. It is all our mindset. If we feel positive or think everything positive happens to us. If we are very negative, we keep on cribbing all the time, negative things will happen. So this can be treated as one of the themes that stay positive in your lives. Clear? Next is second poem. Fire and Ice. It is also written by American poet Robert Frost. Yes, boy. Pay attention here. Fire and ice. Firstly, let me tell you, these two words are symbols. Fire is symbolic of passion. Fine? When you are full of passion, that you can do anything to achieve success in life. Ice is symbolic of insensitive attitude when you do not bother about what is happening around you. Fine. So these two symbols of fire and ice are used to to describe two categories of people by the poet. First category of people who are full of zeal, full of enthusiasm, over passionate, very, you can say, ambitious, over ambitious. They can do anything for the sake of achieving success. Second category of people are icy cold. They are numb. They do not have feelings. They are emotionless. They are insensitive to others. Kuch bhi pass mein ho raha hai, koi jee raha hai, koi mar raha hai. They have nothing to do with it. They are icy cold people. So fire and ice are symbol of two categories of people. Is it clear? Now the main idea of this poem is, poet Robert Frost says that this world will end one day. Fine. Some people believe this world will end in fire, means the people who are having the attributes of fire will be responsible for the end of this world. Some people, second category of people, believe that this world will end in ice, means when insensitivity will increase, when people will become emotionless, that will be the end of the world. Okay, in symbolic meaning, poet is making us understand. But poet Robert Frost, he favors those who favor fire. He feels that both the reasons are equally strong to end this world. But personal choice is fire. Whose personal choice? Robert Frost, poet's personal choice is, I favor those who favor fire. It does not mean he's saying that ice cannot kill the world or end the world. Both can equally end this world, but he personally feels that fire, means traits of fire, can end this world soon. Fine. So unbridled passions, unbridled desires. Agar aapki koi desires hai, wo puri nahi hui. Unbridled, that word I'm using. Fine. Unbridled passions. Then you have that fire in you. Fine. Then you can do anything for the sake of achieving success. Unbridled means yes, which is not fulfilled. Clear? Poet says that he has experienced both these emotions. It does not matter how the world will end. Fine. And it will come to an end for sure. And even icy cold feelings, hatred, disgust, insensitivity, lack of kindness, that is also equally strong enough to end this world. So, dono karan jo hai, dono equally strong hai, but both can lead to the end of this world. Clear? Different beliefs are portrayed in this poem, fire and ice. I'm just, because we have done this in detail, that's why I'm giving the brief description. Our concentration will be MCQs mainly. So last poem, poem number 3, Tiger in the Zoo by Leslie Norris. This poem will be projecting. The tiger is a proud creature. When we, you know, there is a game that I speak a word, you speak a word which comes to your mind after I speak a word. There is a game. If I say cloud, you say rain. Fine. If I say peacock, you say blue. If I say peacock, you say dance. Peacock is famous for dancing. Peacock is blue and green in color. So there is a game. Actually, this game is a psychological game to bring out what goes in your mind. Fine. If I say exams, you will say fear, scared, in that way. So that is a psychological way. Similarly, if I say the word tiger, what comes to our mind? Wild animal, fearless, proud, ferocious. So I'm just giving you one example. Now, if I say tiger in the zoo, does it match? Obviously, when we use the word tiger, hamare mind mein image aata hai forest, free life, ferociousness, tiger prancing and catching its prey. Hame dar lagta hai that if a tiger comes in front of us, it can be, we can get attacked by it. Fine. So such kind of thoughts come to our mind. So the poem is a tiger in the zoo. A tiger. Fine. Aapne bola tha na, there is no article, but there is one article. a tiger in the zoo. Daksh, you are going to answer the MCQs. You are going to answer the questions. You're not listening anything. So, A Tiger in the Zoo by Leslie Norris. Poet Leslie Norris says that it is a shame that such a powerful creature who is ferocious, who is proud, who is elegant, which is untamable, jisko tame karke nahi rakh sakte hain, he should be caged in a zoo. Tiger is meant to be lived in a natural habitat, wildlife, fine. And his presence in natural habitat is actually a necessity to maintain the balance of, you know that in science you have read one creature eats the other eats the other. So a kind of life cycle or balance cycle is maintained. Fine, they are the food items to the other creatures. Many insects are eaten by some other animals. One animal is eaten by, so this is a kind of chain. So if poet is saying tiger is not kept, it is actually imbalance will be created to the food chain of all the animals. And sometimes the tiger may stray into human habitation and he can display his strength, his ferociousness, but he does not harm anyone. Till it is provoked. Jab aap usko provoke karoge, then reaction will come. Otherwise, no reaction. Like human beings, tiger too, you know, wants, everybody loves freedom. Aapko kuch keh diya jata hai, baat mat karo. The kind of stare you give to the teacher. Aapko parents kehte hain, bahar nahi jana hai. Aap ladai karne lagte ho, why? So whenever your freedom is questioned, you people start behaving madly. Similarly, if a tiger is meant for jungle life, how can he be tamed? Fine? Sorry. So he shows he wants freedom in the cage. He is just, yes, Daksh, this is the last chance I'm giving you. If I saw or if I notice you are talking, you can leave the room immediately. Tiger shows his anger and hatred and even defiance. Defiance is when you oppose something by walking up and down only. Clear? He has no other option left with him. He's just walking up and down the cage in the zoo. Human progress should not be at the cost of destroying the natural habitats of untamable, proud animals. So if you want to grow in life, you need not kill those animals. Do not put it into the behind the bars or cage. Let it be natural thing only. This is the time to join the class, na? Part of your class joining now. So, fine, human progress should be made. Should not be made at the cost of such animals. So what does this tiger in the zoo does? Walks in quiet anger. Fine. Terrorizing the village. If he will be out of the cage, he can terrorize the village. But alas, the tiger is not in his natural habitat. So what does he do at the end of the poem? He remains awake till late night. He's not able to sleep. He gazes the stars in the night. He compares his life with the stars. That stars are shining freely, brightly into the sky. He also wants to shine brightly, move comfortably outside the cage. Clear? And what sound could be heard? Patrolling cars who are checking the all the animals in the zoo. That can be could be heard at late night. And tiger is still awake. He's not able to sleep. What is the... Hansi beta? Rage is like anger only. R-A-G-E. When somebody is full of rage, full of anger. What is the favorite hunt of this tiger? Plump deer. Fine. So we have done the, you can say, let's continue with MCQs now. Yes, Vivan, please behave. What is the name of the poet of this poem? I need not even give the options. Aapko pata hai. This poem, Fire and Ice. Robert Frost. Fine. How did, next question is, how did the dust of snow affect the poet? It made him energetic. It made him superior. It changed his mood. None of the above. What was the change of mood? It brought change of mood only. Yes, it is a quiz I am playing on your behalf. Let's see how many marks I will get. What was the mood of the poet in the beginning of the poem? Sad, happy, confused, none. Whatever you people are speaking, I am putting in. So sad mood you have said. I have. This is a kind of quiz. They are asking me to choose and then next. They are not showing the correct answer. What did crow shake on the poet? Dust of tree, dust of snow, dust of land, dust of garden. This is very easy for you, I guess. The site is having easy questions. The crow and hemlock tree symbolize. I'm not giving you option of ill omen. Let me just speak. Now, online children, you can give answer to this Twitter. Bissam was raising continuously his hand. Yes, Bissam beta, what is the answer?
Sorrow.
Okay, you can mute yourself. So Bissam has given sorrow. Yes, this boy, please give your answer. The crow and hemlock tree symbolize sorrow, happiness, celebration, death. I'm putting in, again I'm saying, I'll tell the marks. What does dust of snow represent? Healing power of nature, particles of snow, cool weather, none of the above. This is not the right way, Vivan. At least, yes, Dakshita has raised hand. Dakshita, your answer is beta.
Particles of snow.
Okay, you can mute yourself. What do you say? Particles of snow. I have chosen particles of snow. Most of you are saying this. Name the poetic device used in the line, has given my heart. Name the poetic device used in the line, has given my heart. Alliteration, metaphor, oxymoron, simile. You have not done. Yes, who said alliteration? Has given my heart. Alliteration. What uplifted his mood? Crow, hemlock tree, falling of snow on his shoulder. Ninth question. Why does the poet call it dust of snow? Because snow particles were too tiny. They came over him like dust. They felt like dust. This is very confusing for me also. So you help me in this. Yes, Vivan. Question is confusing. Why does the poet call it dust of snow? Option A, it showed snow particles were too tiny. They came over him like dust. They felt like dust. They looked like dust. Huh? Tanya still thinking. Last option. They looked like dust. I have chosen. Let's see. What are the two negative creatures that Frost used as carriers of positivity? Negative creatures. This is yes, clear. Hemlock tree and crow. View results. Fingers crossed. Aapke teacher ka result along with you. Where is the result? You have completed English 10.1. 7 out of 10. See, this is not a thing. This is a thing to be worried. It means we gave wrong. Let me tell you all the correct answers now. Name of the poet was Robert Frost. How did the dust of snow affect the poet? It changed his mood. Ye hamara theek tha. What was the mood of the poet in the beginning? Sad. Ye bhi correct tha. What did crow shake on the poet? Dust of snow. That is also correct. The crow and hemlock tree symbolize sorrow. Hamara jo wrong hua hai, that is healing power of nature. That Parina was saying. Yes, beta. What does, this is not, this is all together, 10th D is scoring. It means we need to work. Vivan, we need to work upon it. Fine. Now listen to the correct answers. What does dust of snow represent? It represents healing power of nature. Everybody, is it clear? Dust of snow represent? Name the poetic device used in the line has given my heart. Alliteration. Her sound is repeated here. So this is correct. What uplifted his mood? Falling of snow on his shoulder. What does the poet call it? Dust of snow. Now, they have corrected snow particles were too tiny. Fine? Snow particles were too tiny. Yes, beta, baate nahi. It can be considered. Isme sare sahi lag rahe hain. Ye confusing tha, that's why I'm saying. What option is, correct answer is snow particles were too tiny. That's why. Option first, A. What are the two negative creatures? Ab ye dekho, used as carriers of positivity. इसमें हमने हेमलॉक ट्री एंड क्रो को टिक किया था दैट इज रॉन्ग नो फर्स्टली लिसन टू द क्वेश्चन व्हाट आर द टू नेगेटिव क्रीचर्स दैट फ्रॉस्ट यूज्ड एज कैरियर्स ऑफ पॉजिटिविटी हेमलॉक ट्री एंड स्नो इसको करेक्ट किया हुआ है उन्होंने बेटा कैरियर्स ऑफ पॉजिटिविटी जो उसके लिए पॉजिटिविटी लेके आए दिस इज आई गेस मे बी Maybe they have correct given the wrong right answer. Fine. Mujhe to hemlock tree and crow lag rahe. The reason is they seem to be negative, but last mein they were treated as positively by poet. Fine. Okay, online children, is it clear, beta? All the correct answers, give me your feedback. I'm checking if you are paying attention. Dakshita and Visam participated. Rest of the students, yes, you are sending the feedback by showing thumbs up and other things, but Parth need not send emojis and all, okay? Just thumbs up for that. Now let's do other poem. No talking, beta. Poem number 2, Fire and Ice. Same way we will be playing the quiz, okay? What is the dust of snow? Kariye na, ab fire and ice ki turn hai. Chaliye. What is the name of the poet? Everybody knows. Yes, Robert Frost. Next. Why do some people say that the world will end in ice? Because love among people is increasing fast. Because hatred among people is increasing fast. Because lust among people is increasing fast. None of the above. Hatred. बेटा विदाउट थिंकिंग यू आर गिविंग विवान, तेरे तो 50 में से 40 में से मार्क्स नहीं आने ऐसे. यस, व्हाट इज आइस अ सिंबल ऑफ? यस, हेटेड इज वन ऑफ द ऑप्शन, सो आई एम पिकिंग इट आउट फॉर यू. व्हाट एवर यू आर सेइंग आई एम पिकिंग दैट. व्हाट इज फायर अ सिंबल ऑफ? लव एंड न्यू डिजायर्स, लस्ट एंड एंडलेस डिजायर्स, love and beginning of a new thing, revolution. Okay, second option I have chosen for you all. Where has he used personification? Personification is when human qualities are given to objects. Fire, ice, earth, both A and B. Both 1 and 2. Human qualities are given to fire and ice. Name the poetic device used in the line. I guess you're ruining this lecture. I'm doing efforts for you people and you are ruining it. Okay, name the poetic device used in Some Say the World Will End in Fire. Next is rhyme scheme of the poem. Do you have the book? Book देख के पता लगेगा वो. Book में से देख के पता लगेगा बेटा. I'm choosing anything wrong. Okay, A option, but I have not seen it. What would suffice if the world were to perish twice? Ice, fire, hatred, both A and ice would be suffice. पीछे हो जाइए बेटा please. I'm just checking. What does the poet compare fire with? Desire. To say that for destruction, ice is also great. Wait, 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 wait. Let me end this.